everybody. It's Paul with the Anderson team. I am here with my good friend, the president and CEO of Mesa United Way, Mr. Mark Young. And I've given up on pointing because I've realized on Zoom, it mirrors different. So he's right there, one of those two sides. But I wanted Mark to kind of join us. We're wrapping up May, starting June, and give us a little update about some of the great stuff that's happening at Mesa United Way, some of the things that they're engaged with and how we as a community can get engaged and help them out. So thanks, Mark, for joining me for a few minutes. And why don't you bring us up to speed on what's happening over there?
Thanks, Paul. Thanks for having us, having this conversation. I just wrapped up VITA, brought back about $6.5 million in returns to folks, low-income families that got their taxes done. So that's exciting. Everything else is getting up and running. So we are grateful for that. There are some things that we need. 12 Books is doing a great job, but we could use some volunteers there to help us with some online reading tutoring that has been really successful. Actually, volunteers may be the thing we need most right now. And here's why: we lost so many during the pandemic, right? That people couldn't get together and couldn't work. And now that they can, we could use help at Helens. We could use help at the Culver Street campus with Foster 360, at the Vet Center. So if people are interested in just giving some of their time and washing clothes or driving a vet around or reading to kids, we could really use some help. In other tangible ways, this is often a difficult time for homeless folks. So water bottles are great. You know, there's a city drive to do that. One of the things that we know people need are gas cards in the summer. So specifically veterans who are trying to get back and forth to appointments, if we can get them gas cards, people who are trying to get to new jobs, oftentimes they just need that a little bit of help there at the beginning. So a $25 gas card goes a long way in getting people back up on their feet. So we're excited. I think we've got some expansion plans. We're working on celebrating our 100-year anniversary this year. We've got some fun events coming up. Yeah, it's great. And it's interesting, Paul, that 100 years ago, when Mesa United Way started as the Mesa Community League, it was right after the last pandemic. And there were a lot of migrant children, migrant farm workers here who were needing help. And they put together a group of people to do that, to help those folks, and it morphed into United Way. And we'd like to be that relevant for the next 100 years. So we're pretty excited about the stuff we're doing.
That's kind of cool. That's cool timing, right? We're coming out of this pandemic. The amount of work that Mesa United Way has done to help our community, our city, the East Valley, Mesa specifically, in the last year is phenomenal. I know Mark and his team have really stepped up to be a resource, to help our vets, to help those that are in their homes, just to really all around. There's so many amazing things. If you're not familiar with Mesa United Way, hop on their website, give Alicia or I or anybody on our team a call. We would love to talk to you a little bit about what they do. Some of the things that Mark talked about, water bottles, gift cards, those sorts of things too. You can drop those off with us. We'll come pick them up from you. I know Mesa United Way's office downtown, their address is on their website. You can drop it off there, I'm sure. All of those things are great. So, hey, Mark, thanks so much for all you do. We appreciate you and what you do for our community.
Thank you, Paul, for all you guys do and how you continue to keep the needs of our community front and center. Thank you for that.
Thank you, guys. Everybody, thank you so much.